In this video, we'll be going over how to configure your SCADA Data Gateway to work with ICCP or TASE2. We'll be using Dataset Transfer Sets to get data into Gateway, and then we'll also be enabling a Dataset Transfer Set to get the data back out to our SCADA Master. This is our gateway over here on the right, and this gateway will be running in an environment all simulated in our Distributed Test Manager tool. We'll be looking at this briefly from time to time in order to change data and explain concepts. So, in our Distributed Test Manager tool, we have one TASE2 client and one TASE2 server. The models for each of them are shown here and here. So now let's get data inside of our SCADA Data Gateway. Well, first you'll notice we don't have any devices right now. So let's go ahead and add a ICCP or TASE2 client. From here, we can just give it a name. Go ahead and name it ICCP client. And then we'll go ahead and configure it. I know that my server is in DTM, which is at 10.10.10.102. We'll leave the default port of 102. And then the client, where my gateway is at, is 10.10.10.106. And I'll go ahead and hit OK. That'll go ahead and configure and start up the client. Now, we need to go ahead and configure it before we can start pulling data. So I'm going to go ahead and disconnect from the server. And then there's a few ways you can build up the model. You can go into Edit ICCP Client Model and configure it manually here. Or what I'll be doing today is I'll just be connecting up to the server and discovering the model itself. So now that I have connected up to the model and discovered it, I have access to things like the data sets and the dataset transfer sets. So I can right click and you can do a command point set, a pull point set, you can pull a data set, or you can enable dataset transfer sets. That's what I'll be doing in this video. From here, we have access to all the information that I've set up. We have the dataset name, which I just named Matt's Real Q dataset. Here's the data set it's associated with it, and then all of the data inside of it. So I'll go ahead and click that and add the transfer set. Now that we've done that, we'll see that we have a new node out here in the view. This is where the data set is. If you click it, you'll notice that it's blank and there's nothing inside of it. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to add a ICCP item. I'm going to go ahead and add all of the real queues from my data set. And now we'll have those inside of the report here. So if I go into one of the real queues and I change it, let's say to 200, we'll see that value change within the SCADA Data Gateway. So now that that's connected all the way up, we'll need to create a outwardly facing model that another client can enable its dataset transfer set. So I want to get this value over to my SCADA Master. So to do that, I will right click and I'll go down to add a ICCP server. I'll give this a custom name as well. Go down to the server settings. And this is my server setting, which is on my gateway. So that's 10.10.10.106. And then I'll go ahead and hit OK. Now we have a ICCP server here. We need to go ahead and get the value from our client over to our server. So I'll stop the server, that way I can change the model, and I'll go ahead and add a new domain. And like the one from before, I'll name this ICC1. The number of dataset transfer sets is default set to 5, which is fine for my case. Hit OK. And then I can just go to the values I want to map over and just drag and drop them. I'll give it a name to match up with the data type and select the data type for this. Once I've done that, I've got the mapping complete. I can go ahead and restart the server. And then we'll see the value has now been mapped across. You can clear this mapping in two ways. You can click the delete mapping button right here in the ICCP server, or you can go to the source, which is the ICC client, and you'll also see a delete mapping button. The arrow indicates which way the mapping is going. So this real queue is being mapped to ICCP server, ICC1, real queue 0. Then from there, I can go into my client, which in this case, my SCADA Master is being simulated in the Distributed Test Manager tool. So now what I'll need to do is go ahead and connect up my SCADA Master to my SCADA Data Gateway. So I can right-click here, and I can go down to Manage, Connect. We'll see they connected because it turned green. Then I can come into the data set here and see I've got my real queue. And then right-click and do Get Next Available Dataset. I'll provide that new data set that contains the real queue I'm looking for. Hit OK. And now I can right-click, and it is enabled. So if I come in here and I change the value to, say, 600, we'll see those values propagate around the SCADA Data Gateway. And then you can go in and bring it in to DTM. Thanks for watching.